Most people think one drink is harmless. Just a beer after work, a glass of wine with dinner. No big deal, right? Wrong. From the moment alcohol hits your bloodstream, your brain undergoes a neurochemical cascade that affects everything from your mood to your decision-making ability. And it lasts way longer than you think. I'm going to show you exactly what happens to your brain after one drink, minute by minute. And trust me, the timeline will surprise you. Let's start the clock. You take your first sip. What happens next is surprisingly fast. Within just 60 seconds, alcohol is already being absorbed through your stomach lining and entering your bloodstream. Unlike food, alcohol doesn't need to be digested. It passes directly through the stomach wall. Now here's where it gets interesting. Within 5 minutes, just 5 minutes, alcohol molecules reach your brain. How? Because alcohol is both water-soluble and fat-soluble, that means it can slip right through the blood-brain barrier like it's not even there. Your brain's security system? Alcohol just walks past it. The moment alcohol enters your brain, it immediately targets your GABA receptors. GABA, gamma-aminobutyric acid, is your brain's primary inhibitory neurotransmitter. Think of it as your brain's calm-down chemical. It slows neural activity, reduces anxiety, and creates relaxation. Alcohol doesn't just activate GABA, it supercharges it. It enhances GABA's effect, flooding your brain with inhibitory signals. This is why you feel that first wave of relaxation so quickly. Your nervous system is literally being told to slow down. Tension melts away. Stress decreases. And this is all happening in the first 5 minutes. Between minutes 5 and 15, things escalate. Your brain isn't just relaxing anymore, it's being rewarded. Alcohol triggers dopamine release in your nucleus accumbens. This is your brain's reward center, the same region that lights up when you eat chocolate, have sex, or accomplish a goal. This dopamine surge is why drinking feels good. It's your brain saying, "Yes, more of this, please." And here's the critical part. This is the exact mechanism that makes alcohol addictive. Your brain remembers this reward. It wants to repeat it. One drink won't create addiction, but this is the neurological pathway that leads there. At the same time, something else is happening. Your prefrontal cortex, the part of your brain responsible for judgment, impulse control, and social filtering, is starting to go offline. Activity in this region decreases significantly. This is called disinhibition. You know that little voice in your head that says, "Maybe don't say that," or "Probably shouldn't text your ex right now"? That voice is getting quieter. This is why people become more talkative, more confident, and are more willing to take social risks after just one drink. It's not courage. It's your brain's executive function being suppressed. By minute 15, you're feeling the full effect. Relaxed, sociable, slightly euphoric. Your brain is swimming in GABA and dopamine, but the impairment is just beginning. Between minutes 15 and 30, your blood alcohol concentration reaches its peak. For one standard drink, that's 12 ounces of beer, 5 ounces of wine, or 1.5 ounces of liquor, you're looking at a BAC of about 0.02 to 0.03%. That might sound tiny. It's not. You might not feel drunk. You might feel totally fine. But if you had to slam on your brakes right now, your brain would process that threat 5 to 10% slower than normal. This is why even one drink before driving is dangerous. It's not about feeling impaired. It's about your brain literally being unable to process information as quickly as it normally does. Did you learn anything new yet? Let us know in the comments below. Great, let's continue. Between 30 and 60 minutes while you're starting to feel more normal, your liver is in full metabolic mode. Your liver produces alcohol dehydrogenase, an enzyme that breaks ethanol down into acetaldehyde. And acetaldehyde, it's actually more toxic than alcohol itself. This is what causes cellular damage and contributes to hangovers. Your liver can only process about one standard drink per hour. There's no way to speed this up. Not coffee, not cold showers, not sobering up tricks. Your liver works at its own pace. Here's the disconnect most people experience. By 45 to 60 minutes, the euphoria is fading. The dopamine surge is over. You feel more sober, but your cognitive impairment? Still there. Your reaction time? Still decreased. Your judgment? Still compromised. This is the dangerous window where people think, "I'm fine to drive." but their brain chemistry says otherwise. 1 to 3 hours after that single drink, your BAC finally returns to zero. The alcohol is metabolized. You're technically sober again, but your brain isn't quite back to normal yet. Studies show subtle cognitive deficits can persist 2 to 3 hours after your BAC hits zero. Attention span, working memory, reaction time, all still slightly impaired while your brain recalibrates its neurochemistry. And if you drank that one drink in the evening, your sleep is about to take a hit. Alcohol suppresses REM sleep, the restorative stage where memory consolidation and emotional processing happen. Even one drink can reduce your REM sleep by 10 to 20% that night. You might fall asleep faster, but the quality of that sleep is significantly worse. You'll wake up feeling less rested, even if you got 8 hours. The next morning, your brain has fully reset. GABA, glutamate, dopamine, all back to baseline. One drink doesn't cause lasting damage. Your brain is remarkably resilient. But here's the warning. If you drink regularly, your brain adapts. GABA receptors become less sensitive. Dopamine pathways get worn down. You need more alcohol to get the same effect. That's tolerance. And when tolerance builds, withdrawal symptoms emerge when you stop. Anxiety, irritability, sleep problems. Your brain has been chemically altered. So that's what one drink actually does to your brain, minute by minute. From GABA activation in the first 5 minutes to dopamine release and social disinhibition by minute 15, peak motor impairment at 30 minutes, liver metabolism through the first hour, and sleep disruption that night, it's far more complex than just one drink. Understanding this neuroscience doesn't mean you can't drink. It means you can make informed decisions about when, how much, and why. Your brain is the most sophisticated machine in the known universe. Treat it accordingly. If you want to understand how chronic drinking changes your brain long term, check out our video on how alcohol hijacks your brain, the neuroscience.